Dear viewers, today we will see how to find out the lateral spring stiffness for pile using L-Pile V2018. We will use PY curve data for finding the lateral stiffness of pile. Run the software. Here we can go step by step. We can go for program option and settings. Go to program options, conventional analysis mode. Here you can change this unit. I will go for SI unit and loading type static. We can go for cyclic loading as per our requirement. Click on OK. Now pile properties. Here is step 2. Pile properties. I will go for round concrete shaft pile, that means board pile. Click on this shaft dimension, that means pile length. I will go for 18 meter, section diameter 600 millimeter. Concrete, here we can change it to 30 MPa using 30,000 kilonewton per meter square. Maximum coarse aggregate size millimeter 20 millimeter. Then we will go for rebar. Here 415 MPa. Elastic modulus we will use by default. We will go for 20 millimeter dia main bar. Number of bars, here we can see number of bars. Here we can see warning, this rebar case is too tight for aggregate to pass through the spacing between the longitudinal bars. So we will reduce the number of bar here 10, number of 20 millimeter dia bar. Tie rebar, consider confined concrete. We can choose spiral rebar type, bar size 10 millimeter. Number of bars 1, spacing 150, same 415 000, that means 415 MPa. Click on OK. Soil properties, here we can go for soil properties. Now here different soil layers we have to choose as per our soil report. I will go for example here, as I am not using soil report here. We have to use soil report for proper input of soil data. Here I have collected some data for this type of soils. First one I will use soft clay. This one, top of soil layer 0, bottom of soil layer 5 meter. Then add here 5 to 10, add 10 to 15, then add 15 to 20. Another one we can add 20 to 25. So this is the soil depth 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25. Our pile length is 18 meter. Now I will go for first layer soft clay, effective unit weight 11 to 21. Here properties, unit weight 14 14. Here top bottom, top means 0 meter level and bottom means at 5 meter level. Undrained cohesion 12 to 24. I will go for example 18 18. Strain factor here for soft clay 0.02. Okay, remember that I am showing as example only. You will get the proper data from the soil report. Close this one. Now our soil layer properties done. Now I will close this one. Save as. Save this. Now we will go for pile head loading. Here we can provide axial force, shear force, distributed load and moment. I will provide axial force, moment and shear force here as example. Here shear force, for example 75 kN, axial force for example 200 kN, axial force 200 kN and this one condition 2, that means this one for moment kilonewton meter, this one for example 50 kilonewton meter moment. Okay, here you can choose compute top Y versus L. Now close this one. Here we can provide ground slope, pile vector, we can provide angle here like this 30 degree, 10 degree, like this. I will go for vertical pile. Here you can see pile with soil layers. Now we can run the analysis. Analysis completed for all cases. Please check results. Here, this is the results: depth, deflection, bending moment, shear force. Close this one. What we have seen here, we can see separately here. We can see the presentation graph utility. Here we can choose deflection versus depth. Here you can choose soil reaction P versus depth. These two values we will use to find out our lateral spring stiffness. So these values we can get in our Excel file, then from that Excel file we can find out our lateral spring stiffness at different depth of pile. So how to get our data in Excel file? Go to graphics. From here go to export graphs to Excel. Here we need deflection and soil reaction or soil resistance. Now generate Excel file. The Excel file generated. This is the data and this is the graph. This is the data for soil reaction and this is the graph. This is depth data and this side this is the deflection data, and here this side soil reaction, this side depth data. So now I will select the depth column for pile, then I will copy here and paste. Now I will go for soil reaction here, copy, paste, and here this one lateral deflection, copy, then here paste. Now we have to choose our depth intervals where we want to provide the lateral spring stiffness. It is recommended that the depth interval will not be more than the pile diameter. So our pile diameter is 600 millimeter, so I will use below 600 millimeter pile dia. So first one 0, then I will go for 0.54 meter, that means 540 millimeter. In between these two I will delete. Now 0.54 interval, then I can mark here this one, then this one. Now in between these two intervals we will delete the data. So done. Now here we can find horizontal spring stiffness P by Y. Here soil resistance P, deflection Y. So here this one divided by this one. Then we can drag these cells to get the values. From top to bottom, this horizontal spring stiffness will be increase gradually. This horizontal spring stiffness values we can use in our structural programs like ETABS, STATPRO, SAP 2000, etc. for modeling our pile. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more important tutorials. And
press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.